The loss of the Liberty Bell 7 capsule deals a severe blow to the American space program and leaves her commander's reputation in tatters.
Finally, in 1999, the lost capsule is raised from the ocean floor. But can she help solve the mystery of what went wrong?
It was an opportunity to finally look at the physical, hard evidence of the condition of the capsule and to understand what happened.
However, crucially, the hatch door is not found. And despite extensive investigation, the capsule does not provide definitive answers to the many questions that remain. The investigations are wound up, but some people are still determined to find answers. Years pass before NASA agrees to open up its archive to writer and Grissom biographer George Leopold.
I think that the loss of Liberty Bell 7 is probably one of the great mysteries.
With the passage of time, he's hoping that a cold, objective eye will unearth some fresh clues. One piece of eyewitness testimony stands out. Lieutenant John Reinhardt, one of the retrieval team, is first on the scene. His job is to remove the capsule's antenna before attaching the winch hook from the helicopter.
He was in the helicopter opening with a hook and a snipper, and he said that when he touched this ungrounded spacecraft, he saw an arc.
A powerful electrostatic discharge.
You've got a helicopter hovering over a spacecraft and this vortex that's got a lot of energy in it. And when metal touches metal, some of that energy is probably going to get transferred, and that's what John Reinhardt thought he saw.
He was the closest person to the spacecraft when he sees this arc. And at that moment, the hatch blows.
The warm, humid weather on that day provides near ideal conditions to supercharge the prop wash, generating enough static electricity to potentially detonate the explosives.
So that leaves us with, you know, the possibility that maybe it was the electrostatic discharge that blew the hatch.